Hello friends, welcome to the Nik Academy. Myself Shivaji Kale. In today's current affairs decoded discussion, we are going to take the newspaper of 30th March. In this, the Hindu newspaper, on the editorial page, they have given a very nice article about the deep void in the global leadership. Now, this article actually tries to analyze the evolution of and the necessity of global leadership, and in the recent decades, how the global leadership has shifted to parochial narrow national interests. And this recent health epidemic phenomena has again showed the world that it is necessary to have a global leadership. So actually, in the modern history, if we see, it was after the Second World War, and particularly after the establishment of United Nations, we can say the shared vision of world was shown. And they believed that this collective action is the only way forward to prevent the occurrence of World War III. Now we haven't seen any incidents of World War III, though there were a lot of situations that developed a stress that can create a situation similar to World War III. But now we can also say that this health epidemic is similar to a world war only, where war is against the virus. So, this particular situation demands a global leadership. But we do see that in the recent period of time, actually, the world is moving toward parochial narrow interest. So we can say national interest is now taking precedence over the larger interest. How do we see this tide of anti-globalization? So this article gives us two reasons for it. First reason that they are trying to give is a swing toward right-wing nationalization. So this nationalism or nationalization is a political concept, or you can consider it as a polity related concept, where the interest of the nation comes first against any other interest. And this type of tide has already been seen in many of the countries, including India, isn't it? So USA mein hai, uske baad mein many countries are showing similar type of right-wing nationalism. So, they believe that global good is in conflict with the national interest. So, that is the thing which we can simply observe in the case of America First policy of USA, isn't it? Where their economic interest they have put against, or their economic interest they have put more important than the interest of the other countries. And hence you are seeing that they are trying to affect multiple institutions that are trying to have a multifloral trade initiatives. WTO ka usme sabse jyada relation aayega, hai ki nahi? To aapko sabko pata hoga ki WTO ki jo dispute resolution mechanism hai, body hai, उसको उन्होंने क्रिपल डाउन कर दिया है. दे आर सिंपली वेटिंग द प्रपोजल्स ऑफ रिक्रूटिंग द न्यू जजेस. ठीक है, तो WTO हो गया या यूनाइटेड नेशन भी देखो आप, कम पावरफुल हो रहा है. एंड इन द रिसेंट केस WHO, विच इज आल्सो अ ग्लोबल बॉडी टू कोऑर्डिनेट अमंग द मेंबर कंट्रीज, हैज आल्सो प्रूवन लेस इफेक्टिव. तो ये क्यों हो रहा है? तो एक्चुअली इफ यू कैन सी इन दिस पर्टिकुलर कोरोना वायरस स्प्रेड, as you are aware that it has started in Wuhan district of China. So, China delayed the reporting of this world virus to the World Health Organization. If they would have informed the WHO and other countries and United Nations, the other countries would have taken the precautions. But they delayed the reporting. Similarly, after the virus spread to different parts of the world, especially the USA, USA has unilaterally stopped its flight from European Union region. They haven't informed the European Union. So if you compare this with the Indian leadership in the recent period of time, Indian leadership has shown more mature response to this global epidemic. Is it? Our Prime Minister is seen talking to the SAARC countries and asking the SAARC members to have a combined strategy. Also, they have started with a SAARC fund. Even in the G20 summit, our leadership is asking for the combined efforts to challenge this particular global epidemic. So this G20 is seen as a hope because these are the group of 20 countries that are most industrialized, most economically prosperous countries. So obviously they will be having more strength to tackle this epidemic, and hence the responsibility comes to the shoulders of these 20 countries, and they are also shown the intention in doing so by starting its own fund. But when they will decide to do it, decide collaborative efforts, global efforts under the global leadership to tackle the recent health epidemic or in the future such type of any global problem, they need to have some aspect into the mind. For this particular recent health epidemic, they need to focus on multiple aspects. So for the first thing, they need to focus upon stepping up the production. Why? Because many of the countries are under lockdown, hence the production of goods and services has halted. But some of the countries who were the beginners for this infection spread, like China, Japan, South Korea, they have now resumed their industrial and other activities. So, these countries need to take the production and need to meet the increasing demand from the other countries. Now, when they will produce something, it is very important to ensure the seamless logistic for the supply chain for the essential goods and services. So whatever are the logistical challenges, trade barriers and other challenges that are there, legal or otherwise, should be removed for this particular period of time. With that, there is also very important thing that need to be taken care of, is to exchange the authenticated information on the clinical solutions. Because if you remember, in the yesterday's newspaper only, we were discussing about the different efforts that researchers are taking. Again, anti-malaria drug use kar rahe hai, HIV ka combination drug use karne ki koshish kar rahe hai. So, whenever they are conducting trials at their own countries or own research labs, whatever the findings they will have, they should share that with the scientific community so that this collaboration on the laboratory trials and clinical validation will help us in developing in the near future the vaccine or antiviral drug. By doing this type of things, we need to involve the private sector also. Okay. So private sector involvement becomes again important. Now, as we are aware that WHO has already said that whatever we do, how much we fast track the process, it will take at least 18 months to prepare the vaccine. So even if we reduce the time, it is going to take a bit of time. In that particular period, we need to focus on moving the trained health professionals like doctors, nurses, paramedics, etc. across the world to the area where it is most important. Now, these are all the aspects that are important in an immediate scenario. But in the next immediate scenario, that is after say a couple of months or a next agricultural season, we need to also focus upon anticipated food shortage. Now, food shortage can be because of different reason. Say, because of it is available, but it is not reaching to the people because the shops are not available or etc. etc. But think about the aspect that agricultural produce that is into the farms is not reaching to the market. So we need to find about the solutions to tackle these particular issues. So understood this particular article? It's a very good article, very analytical article, important for the mains examination. Now, in this particular article only, they are talking about herd immunity. Now, this is a different concept, important for the preliminary examination. तो इसको समझ लेते हैं, देखो थोड़ा सा. Herd immunity का concept क्या है? तो, basically, they are saying that it is a form of indirect protection. कैसे? From the infectious disease. उसमें दो चीज़ भी आप कर सकते हो. कैसे? एक तो आप man-made तरीके से herd immunity develop कर सकते हो, which can be developed through the vaccination. तो vaccination देंगे, for example, polio vaccination दिया जाएगा सब बच्चों को. तो no person will get affected because all the herd means the group of the population will be immune to that particular virus. तो अगर polio virus exist भी करता है, तो भी वो किसी को health effect नहीं करेगा. तो in this particular case, United Kingdom scientists are saying that when they are tackling the coronavirus, they will say that they are planning to reduce its impact, but they will not eliminate it completely, so that if that particular viral strain remain in the region in a lower say strength, it will help to increase the immunity to the people which it will in contact with. Theek hai? So now this type of strategy they want to implement in their own country. Now many of the people globally are criticizing this particular policy because they are saying that this novel coronavirus is a new type of virus, and actually people are more susceptible to the infection rather than developing the herd immunity. But for our preliminary examination, this becomes an important concept to remember. All right. Now to the next news on the page 16, that is life. The news talks about air quality improves in over 90 cities. So here in this news, I have already highlighted the important aspect, that is system of quality and weather forecasting and research, that is SUFFER, is the actually initiative that measures the air quality in the particular region. And also in the subsequent columns, they are talking about AQI, that is Air Quality Index. So, ye dosto samajh lete hain, and detail note I will also put it on Telegram channel. So, system of air quality and weather forecasting and research jo hai, that is SUFFER, is an initiative of Ministry of Earth Science, where they measures two aspects actually, weather parameters and pollutants, Weather parameters may they also check like temperature, humidity, wind speed, direction, solar radiation, kya hai, etc. etc. And in pollutants, they observe different pollutants. PM 2.5, PM 10, that are particular matters according to the sizes. And ozone bhi check karte hai, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxides, sulfur dioxide, benzene, toluene, xylene and mercury. These are the pollutants. This suffer. इनिशिएटिव मेजर्स एक्चुअली आपने देखा होगा कि बड़ा सा बोर्ड लगाया होता है जिसपे कलर कोडिंग में डिफरेंट क्वालिटी ऑफ एयर पोल्यूटेंट के अनुसार डिफाइन करते हैं. नो एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स इज लिटिल बिट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. ठीक है, दिस रिपोर्ट्स द डेली एयर क्वालिटी एंड द मेजर एयर पोल्यूटेंट्स इन द एयर विच हैव अ हेल्थ इफेक्ट्स. तो उसमें आठ ही एयर पोल्यूटेंट्स मेजर करेंगे. देखो थोड़े उसमें से कॉमन है सफर के साथ, कुछ अलग भी है तो थोड़ा सा डीप से देख लेना क्या क्या है उसमें. देखो पीएम 2.5, पीएम 10 ओजोन, ग्राउंड लेवल ओजोन, दिस थ्री आर कॉमन. कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड भी है वहाँ पे, सल्फर ऑक्साइड भी है, नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड भी है, ये सारे उसमें कॉमन है. छः और अलग कौन से है, अमोनिया एंड लीड आर द डिफरेंट दैन सफर. एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स एंड सफर इसमें से पोल्यूटेंट्स को थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है देख लेना. इसको मैं डाल देता हूँ टेलीग्राम चैनल पे, वहाँ से आप एक बार और रिवाइज कर लेना. उसके बाद न्यूज़ है, देखो अर्जुन देव लीजेंडरी हिस्टोरियन पासेस अवे. अर्जुन देव सर आपको सबको पता ही होंगे, वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री की उनकी एनसीईआरटी हम लोग पढ़ते थे, है कि नहीं, तो अभी वो गुजर गए हैं. ओके, कमिंग टू द लास्ट न्यूज़ ऑफ टूडेज डिस्कशन इज अबाउट हिमालयन ईबेक्स. Now this particular animal, ठीक है, is recently studied by Zoological Survey of India and has quoted or proved that it is different than or distinct species than the Siberian ibex. अभी क्या है, तो पहले this Himalayan ibex is considered to be a subspecies of this Siberian ibex only. Siberian ibex actually क्या होता है, it's a wild goat. ठीक है, तो अगर आप देखोगे तो very peculiar thing about this particular animal is that it is spread in a diverse habitat. तो ठंड एरिया में भी रहते हैं like Siberia, mountainous region में भी रहते हैं like Mongolia, and they are distributed to different parts of steppe regions also. ठीक है, तो IUCN की category थी उसकी least concern है, so that is not an important aspect to remember. But recently Himalayan ibex को genetic code को study करके Zoological Survey of India has come to the conclusion that it is a different species than the Siberian ibex. ठीक है, तो ये लडाख और जम्मू और हिमाचल प्रदेश के हिमालयन रेंजेस में पाया जाता है. ठीक है, तो इसको थोड़ा सा देख लेना, उसका इमेज देख लेना, मैं डाल देता हूँ इस पर टेलीग्राम चैनल पे, तो आपको आसानी होगी समझने में. ठीक है, सो दैट इज ऑल फॉर टुडेज डिस्कशन. सो आई विल पुट ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट रिलेटेड टू टुडेज डिस्कशन इन डिफरेंट फॉर्मेट ऑन द टेलीग्राम चैनल. So, you are supposed to go through that while listening to this particular article. ठीक है? So, from today, I am signing off. Take care. Bye-bye.